Alright, today I'm doing a set of Elf wings with a little bit of a twist. This set of wings is going to have some fabric embedded in them. So you can see the clear panel in the middle of the underside, and then the curved panel on the top side of the wing there. And they are going to get on the underside, is getting that cloth, and the top side is getting a matching cloth. You can see it's been cut to the shape, so it will sit over there basically like that. So this is a bit of an experiment, and we'll see how it goes. As far as the rest of the prep, this is the trailing edge material which goes behind the carbon, a 12k carbon toe which runs on the trailing edge to keep it stiff, and then there is the carbon D-box, as you can see, runs half the sort of wing, I suppose. Alright, I'll try and work on the far side of the bench as much as I can today so that I'm not blocking the camera. I just thought it'd be good to make a video about this one. I haven't tried the fabric before. Fairly standard setup for the core. It's already got the holes burned in it for the servo wires. Just gets a single hinge because it use a spoiler on, and this is, you know, around 200 gram carbon on the leading edge. Yep. Put on with transfer adhesive tape. Yep. So this is a fairly straightforward sort of build. This is going to be interesting. Okay, I'll mix some resin, and I don't know if I've shown you this before, but these are my epoxy sheets. This one's for the Lunatic. It shows basic dimensions of the wing, so you can refer to control surfaces or whatever. But the main table is about how much epoxy do you use for what component. I have a notebook that I kept, you know, obviously, notes about every build I did, and I was sick of looking back through it. I can't find the Elf one at the moment, so luckily I have it on my phone. So here we go. The wings will be 60 grams of resin and 15 grams of hardener, and it may take a little bit of extra to wet the core out, is what the note says. So there you go, 60 and 15 it is. Okay, I should add that I put an extra 10 grams of mixed resin into this mix because the fabric will definitely need some more resin. So I've now mixed up 68 plus, what's that, 34, 17. So 85 grams of resin. Okay, so we're pretty much ready to go. Get out of the road, get our roller ready. Much of this will be very standard, and I'll just zip through it. Speed the video up for you. And we'll see how we go. But anyway, gotta make sure you mix the epoxy properly to start with. Now, just got to remember to do the fabric before I start putting everything else in. Right now, normally I'd be putting the carbon straight in there. Now I'm going to make sure these are pretty loaded up here where the fabric's going to go, because it's just going to slurp the resin up, and I don't want it to be dry on the outside. Okay, let's try it. Cut this so it should sit inside the mylar. I don't want to be trying to cut this fabric when I'm trimming this stuff off. And doesn't need to be right to the trailing edge, because that will get trimmed off once it's all cured and set up. Got to remember to keep breathing when you do this stuff. I'm also resigned to the fact that I may have to mix more resin and make these wings slightly heavy. It's going to be a slope plane anyway, so it won't matter that much. And it's right on the CG, so it's just the dead weight of it. It's not like it's adding extra balance weight or anything then. But I'd rather have it slightly heavy than have it dry. All right. Okay, so if I get some on here, I can just let it soak in. I also took the precaution of putting a coat of clear paint down where these are, so it's not just the resin surface, so that should help a bit. Okay. Well, that looks to have wet out really well. I'll put a photo up of the test piece I did, which was an elf tail plane with a bit of blue foam behind it, and with a couple of strips of the 12K tow behind it, and you can actually see the tow running through. So on this one, you'll see the line where the, it'll be darker above and lighter below, where the D-box goes. But that's all okay. All right, let's try this guy. Okay, this one's going to be more interesting. I'm going to trim this end. See, it doesn't need to be all that careful, because bandage will run over the middle of that when the wing gets joined anyway, so all these things you've got to think about. really hope this turns out well. Okay, as I mentioned, split these. Okay. Okay, that looks pretty good. Gonna mix some more resin and we'll see how we get on. So this is an extra 40 grams. So, you know, maybe an extra 100 grams to the airframe. Depending on how much of this squeezes out too when it's under vacuum. Put some extra paper towel around it. See what we get. Okay, next step, before we get the core ready, I always cut this stuff out.